Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1/72 scale Char Zaku 2 Origin version. And that model kit from Gundam Central. Link is in the description below. So, I think this is the first overblown mobile suit. I've reviewed some of the like weapons and I think some backpacks that were like blown up. Only a couple from like 100. I don't think anything from 144 blown up to this size. Granted, it's 1/72, so it's a little awkward. But it looks amazing. I'll just bring in the, there's the Origin Zaku, the actual Origin Zaku. Man, it's quite different. Like, you can tell it's the same, right? It's just very big. But also, it is different. Let's see if I can remember everything. They changed the head so that instead of rotating the camera from underneath the chin, it's actually you have to take the helmet off, and it has a clear visor over top, and the bottom eye is clear pink. Or that's a stinger. The chest is different, because you got molded in Vulcans. You still have the original chest piece if you want to use it for some reason. Without the Vulcans. Because I think this also had like the ones with and without, so you can change if you want. The hosing on the chest and the legs now have springs in them, and they're individual pieces instead of just being one piece of plastic. The shoulder armor is different, but I'm not 100% sure why, but it was included there. The wrist gauntlets, right here, these are new because these are just two halves of plastic, and that's a new cover. The legs on the back have individual gray pieces, same thing with the top of the backpack. You got thrusters on the bottom to cover up these holes here from the backpack. And I think the feet are different. Because they actually have separate panels here on the bottom of the feet where I think these are just... or maybe not. I don't know. They were on the list, so there's something different about them. I'm not exactly sure what, though. Now, I think articulation is basically the same. So you've got a ball-jointed neck and a head with a hinge. Arms can hinge forward. Torso's supposed to. It's very tight. This one can go out about that far. This one can go out a little farther. Rotate below the shoulder. Double-jointed elbow. Ball-jointed wrist. You've got a ball joint in the waist. The ball joint in front skirts, ball joint in side skirts, legs can go forward, back some, out, rotate the thigh, double joint knee, and the foot can go forward and back, tilt, rotate some, and then it has that weird movement with the heel and the foot together, which is very tight. The whole thing is very tight kit. I'm not ever worrying about it falling over, that's for sure. Oh, and you also have a, normal helmet, so if you don't want the command antenna, you got a flat one. Comes with two of the heat hawks, which just slide into the hand, like usual. You also get two of the holding hands, one open hand, and one trigger finger hand. And the heat hawks you can peg onto the side skirt, or you can peg onto the back skirt. Which I think I'll choose the back skirt. And then we have the bazooka, which looks pretty nice. Got a movable handle, extra handle, and scope, which has a clear pink piece. Got the removable ammo. And you've got a couple extra ones you can peg onto the shield, just like the Origin. And it has a peg on either hand, but like I said, you only have one trigger finger hand, which I have on the long rifle. Or is it an anti-ship rifle? Something like that. Another clear pink piece, which is new. Doesn't really do anything other than look cool. And it'll come onto the hand. And you can, oopsie, and you can use the other hand to hold it. And that can store the bazooka onto the clip in the back. So if you want, you can have every single accessory on the kit at the same time. And that's it for the 1/72 scale Origin Char Zaku. I don't have any perfect grades I can really compare right now, but here it is next to the perfect Zeon, which I think is appropriate. considering the Zeon is another Char suit. Now that's a master grade, and it's about the height. It's a little taller than the Arc 72 160 scale perfect grade. So I think you can tell how, like, how different a 172nd scale kit is. Like, it's a weird scale, which I hope we get more, because this is completely out of left field. An oversized 144 kit. Just imagine the possibilities. Anyways, that's about it. If you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.